The Minister of Energy and Mineral Development, Ruth Nankabirwa, presented a statement during today's afternoon plenary sitting explaining the cause of the emergency shutdown, which he attributed to flooding at Isimba Dam that submerged the powerhouse.
The cause of the shutdown of Isimba was not due to too much water, rainwater, outside. Read my report properly.
Please, Honourable, continue. You're protected.
The plant flooded by water which ingressed into because of the works, maintenance works, not because of the too much water, rain water. This is, please read the report.
Please.
Right, Honourable Speaker, I come from that area. I want to be clear on this. Right, Honourable Speaker, the issue that happened was not flooding. Right, Honourable Speaker, the issue was technical, and there are chances that it was intentional. Right, Honourable Speaker, I need the Minister to take interest in this. The people that are managing Isimba are the same people that are managing the thermal in Namanve and so on. Right, Honourable Speaker, take interest. After the shutdown of Isimba, the cost of thermal for this country that you will see.
Nankabirwa assured Parliament that Uganda Electricity Generation Company Limited, the UEGCL, will restore power production at Isimba Hydropower Plant within 3 weeks. The Energy Minister told Parliament that immediately after the emergency shutdown, they resorted to importing 60 megawatts of power from Kenya, which has since reduced to 30 megawatts, with other interventions, including thermal power.
Right, Honourable Speaker, everybody knows what we call a connivance here. Right, Honourable Speaker, we don't want to close to... Me, I'm submitting and I've asked the Minister, because we want the Minister... The Minister has committed to you, Right, Honourable, that in 3 weeks they will restore Isimba. Right, Honourable Speaker, through your office, request the Minister to come back here after 3 weeks and see whether she will have restored Isimba. It's not possible.
The Minister's statement attracted concerns from legislators and the Deputy Speaker, wondering how the newly commissioned Isimba Dam was submerged in floods when the rain season is just starting.
We also have a fear. Because when you say at the beginning of rains, Isimba has flooded, what about when it starts raining seriously? Some areas haven't even received any rain. We have just started receiving rains and flooding has taken the dam. Now what about when it starts raining El Nino?
Speaker, I want to know the impact on the tariff after we have imported and after the shutdown. May I know the impact, how it will affect the consumer?
Legislators blame this shutdown to the technical glitches in the dam, which were glaring at the time of its commissioning.
I would have expected the Minister to tell us that after commissioning that project, they were still, either it was still running within the defects liability period or not. Such an outlay of such amount of money normally requires such that when it is commissioned, there should be parallel running of the project with the contractor and the team that will take over. She should have also told us whether there was such a provision.
It is either the connivance issue or it is the normal issues of procurement and corruption in this country, where we run for things where we can, you know, make out our own fortunes very fast.
MPs put the Minister to task to explain how Uganda, which produces surplus electricity, can import power from Kenya when government is battling with dimmed energy.
If a dam that generates 183 megawatts breaks down, when you have excess power, there is no way the Minister can come on the floor of Parliament and say that we are importing power from Kenya because of the situation in Isimba. Right, Honorable Speaker, I want to propose that this Parliament institutes an investigation in the energy sector in this country.
Parliament has directed the Committee of Natural Resources to investigate the alleged overflooding at Isimba Power Dam.
We have said the committee should go, that's number one. Where they find challenges, they can come back to the presiding officer. and we shall work out mechanisms. But the committee will be supported strongly to ensure that they do their work.
Reports by Fred Kajubi for the news.